It went from taking pictures to this.
Navia's macaron specifically?
They're gonna pull a Marcel again, aren't they?
This world doesn't deserve you.
Hey, since I keep this channel ad-free,
please consider subscribing to my other channel that I'll be moving to in the future. You can also donate to me on Ko-Fi or watch me live on Twitch and check out my live channel.
So come follow and subscribe to me there. Links are down in the description. Thank you. Enjoy the video.
What's up, doggos? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact reaction video. And you've let's fucking talking again. Welcome to another Genshin Impact reaction video. This one being Navia's story quest on 4.3's launch day. And before we get to that, we are going to do the very exciting part each time a patch goes live, which is banner pulls. I'm scared. I don't have a guarantee. And I have her summoning circle ready. Please. I'm at 36 pity. I'm hoping to get her early, or at least if I lose out on the 50-50, I lose early. May the president of Spina di Rusula come home early. First end pull, we're going to 46 pity. What the fuck? See, it's fine. At least I lost early, so that's fine, right? Okay. Nope. Shit. 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 Good. There we go. There she is. No double. Sorry. Ooh. Damn, woman. Oh, wow. Put her umbrella on standby and then take off her glasses. Come at ya. Oh,
wow. Holy Jesus.
Bro, what?
Huh?
Did you see that? 36,000. Putting that aside, we're gonna start the story quest. Rosa Multiflora, Chapter Act 1. Braving the Tides Together. Except... quests. Shimmering Memories. Go to the Court of Fontaine. One day you are stopped by a familiar voice while in the Court of Fontaine.
Well, hey, if it isn't my dear partners.
That voice! It's Navia!
Navia! Ah, that smile! I don't think I can take anymore. It's so bright.
I didn't expect to run into you guys here today. Are you headed somewhere?
No plans in particular.
How about you, Navia? Are you still busy rebuilding Poisson?
We've wrapped up most of the rebuilding, but there are still a few things left to take care of. Stocking up on materials, confirming construction timelines, discussing compensation terms with families affected by the disaster. Between all of that, I've been making a lot of trips between the court and Poisson.
Wasn't Spina di Rusula affected too? Should you really be the one offering compensation?
Well, though the victims have received relief payments from the court, in my opinion, as the administrators of Poisson, Spina di Rusula should take some responsibility as well. Our financial situation right now isn't the best, so all we've been doing is signing agreements for the damages to be repaid at a later date.
Can you imagine the fees?
They're necessary to restore the people's faith in us.
Spoken like a true president! You're a really responsible leader. That must be taking up most of your time, though, right?
I wonder how young is Navia.
Oh, you bet. Between that and all the other errands I have to run at the court, I'm
20s?
Always forgetting one thing or another. So before I came over this time, I took a page from Alusa's book and decided to make a list of everything. This way, it's easy to see which tasks you haven't checked off. And then, since Malus loved using shorthand, I decided to also follow his example and come up with some shorthand of my own.
Even when they're gone, she's being guided by them. Christ.
I'm kind of struggling to even read my own handwriting anymore.
Hey, it's alright. We can help out. We're free.
So, what kind of shorthand did you use?
Oh, wanna take a look?
Lip Hymancy! Wait, there's nothing here but a bunch of weird symbols. This looks like a piece of kelp wrapped around a stick. And this other one, is it supposed to be a boar in a box?
The first one has to do with confirming the final payment amount for the fishermen, while the second one is a reminder to try the new burger that just hit the market. These are the kinds of things you only really figure out once you've tried them out yourself.
I get the feeling she's a little lost after, you know, Malus and Silver. I mean, like, apart from Malus and Silver, she doesn't really have anyone that looks over her as much as they did.
I should have already taken care of most of the things on the list. There are still a few symbols that I can't decipher, but I don't think they're anything too super important.
Ah, so you're going to head back now?
Let's come with you.
Actually, since we talked about the reconstruction earlier, want to come with me and check out the town for yourself?
I'd love to. Is the boss as fast as the one in the demo? I've never seen that. It's highlighted in yellow. I mean, obviously, I'd want to take her boats.
All right, follow me. I'll take you there.
What would have happened if I didn't pick that option?
The engineer is still doing a few routine safety checks. We can head out as soon as we get the green light.
The three Aquabus lines are all named after people in your family, right?
Yeah, that's right. Callus and Navia are self-explanatory, while Clementine was the name that my mother went by.
Sabina de Rusula was one of the main sponsors for the construction, right?
If you provided the Mora to build the lines, then why isn't there even a dedicated line to Poisson?
What I heard is that most of our businesses don't actually use Poisson as a hub. So there was no real reason to build a line straight to Poisson. Well, it is what it is. You know what my father was like. Even I often struggled to figure out what was going on in his head.
Perhaps the rest of the Spina didn't see a point in having a fourth line.
But that would only be the case if he cared about what others thought.
My
father was always really stubborn. Once he made up his mind, good luck getting him to change it.
I like more Aquabus lines. The guys are adorable.
Well, that explains why you weren't on the greatest of terms with him.
Yeah, because I wouldn't just let him keep getting his way. He was just not very agreeable.
Boss, the boat's ready. We can head out.
All right, then let's head out.
Oh, so if we pick the other option, do we miss out on this entire segment? Oh, wow. Whoa, what a title card
to
start.
It'll be a while before we get to Poisson. Let's keep talking.
Navia, what was your mother like as a person? Oh, Paimon, sorry. She totally forgot that you mentioned before that she passed away during childbirth. So
Paimon.
I don't remember her at all.
That's all right. I've heard many stories about her from the rest of the Spina. They've always said that they were sure we would have gotten along famously.
This is like the same thing with, like, when we took the Aquabus from...
If you leave the dialogue running, would you just end up getting to the main city before the thing finishes? And
for example, reporting on how... Oh.
My father would run the businesses and expand our reach, while my mother would keep the peace and make sure that everyone was happy. Their work made sure that the Spina could grow and thrive. Sometimes, I'd still look at the Clementine line and wonder... Would the Spina and Poisson still be what they are today had my mother survived?
I love these shots, they always do these.
Silver once said that a name is a kind of inscription, a way to etch a memory into the world. When given a name, a cold, inanimate object can gain a completely new meaning. So I will always associate the line with her in my heart. Over the past few weeks, I've also begun to appreciate how water can take in and hold our most intense feelings and memories, as well as how one may reflect on their past by watching the sea.
As you are right now.
I've lost many beloved people and memories to the sea. Even though I cannot stop for them and must continue to keep moving, the fact won't change that they existed in my life and gave me the reason and motivation to move forward.
Do you miss them? Missing Malus and Silver? Of course she does.
Always. But no matter what, we can't change the past. I tell myself that I need to keep looking towards the future. Everyone, even my parents, have already overcome so many obstacles. Besides, I'm the president of Spina di Rosula. I've got to keep my chin up.
You've got to take time to, like, recuperate too. You've lost so much. It'd be traumatizing for anyone.
Let's go. I'll show you the new Poisson.
See, I know. I'm worried too.
Navia, do you think she's doing all right?
She's always been having to cope with one thing or another. I don't like how much Genshin threw at her. I really don't.
Paimon supposes you're right. She's really been through a lot. It couldn't have been easy shouldering so much by herself.
Someone as positive as Navia, even someone like her, you know, sometimes people can have... There's a breaking point for them. Sometimes things will just be too much. She's strong, you know. Navia's strong. Oh, hey.
Boss, you're back!
Sorry for suspecting you. It's like, if you're, like, your character's too happy in a Hoyoverse game, it's kind of like a red flag already. It's kind of like the same case with Kiana, no? Kiana in Honkai Impact, she might be a bit of a nuthead, but she's the brightest and most cheerful of all the trio, you know, of Raiden, Mei, and Brania. And look what she had to go through.
We did hand over some of Malus's old responsibilities to Florent, though. It's been really nice to have him around to help out.
Thank you for the compliment, boss. I've been working closely with the boss on rebuilding Poisson. Mr. Malus was an extremely capable and respected member of the Spina. I've got some really big shoes to fill.
Did we manage to make any progress on the statue?
Yeah, we contacted a sculptor about the job. But they can't get started on sourcing a correctly sized block without knowing the design that we want to use first.
Is this like a tribute to Malus and Silver?
We've been meaning to commission a statue of my parents in commemoration of everything they've done for the Spina and the town of Poisson.
Still a tribute, pretty much.
Now that his name has been cleared, and the town is also being rebuilt,
I
thought this would be the perfect chance to actually realize this dream.
The funds to build the statue were freely donated by the people of Poisson. To show their appreciation for Miss Clementine and Mr. Callis, and everything they did.
Shouldn't Navia be featured with them too?
Me? I'm just the newbie president that's running around and causing everyone
trouble. You're doing a fantastic job.
Maybe we can have this conversation again in a few decades, once I've done more for the town and the people.
In a few decades? Navia, I don't know if I can stay that long. Ah, it's making me think of the future patches where one day we have to leave Fontaine again, just like we did with Sumeru. When Dia came to say goodbye to us for Sumeru, God, that made me feel so sad. They're gonna make Navia the one to say goodbye to us for Fontaine, isn't it? Navia or Farina? Farina more probably.
I also believe that Ba should have a place on the statue.
If you keep inflating my ego like this, I might just float off into the sky with my parasol.
Like Mary Poppins.
Now it's up to us to confirm the final design, right?
But we haven't had any real discussions yet on the possible designs. I feel like I should get a few promising designs first, and then send them over to you to review.
There's no need for all that. Let's decide on a design right now. Hey, you! Come over here with me.
Oh, alright, okay.
Just pretend to be Callis, and I'll be Clementine.
I'm not as tall as your dad, though.
Didn't you say on the boat that Callis and Clementine sounded like great partners? Well, then there's no one better to fill this role than my most valuable partner.
You've got it, boss. I'll go get the camera.
Would it work?
No.
Well, what do you think? Got any ideas? I want to pick your brain for a bit and see if you can come up with some new and interesting ideas.
Feel free to start posing whenever.
Okay, then let's try for something imposing. I'm Callus, the dad. Let's do looking out into the distance.
Do you mean as if we were standing on a boat and looking out at the sea? Sure, let's give that a try.
I'm shorter than you though, Navia. Feels weird.
Look over there, my dear Clementine. As you can see, every tree on that island is dripping with mora fruit.
But there's something off with the composition. This pose makes Mr. Callis look too tall next to the lady.
But what? How? I'm shorter, though.
Oh, I see what you mean. Then let's swap.
Oh. Okay, so I'm like... Wait, who's Mr. Callis now?
Well, Paimon is a fan. A statue like this would look fantastic on a boat.
We're not gonna come to an agreement with this, are we?
Oh, okay. We'll try to think of something else.
Try a happy pose?
A happy pose? You mean... something like we were laughing together at a funny joke?
Would all that be able to come through with just a picture?
Would we even be able to tell what they are supposed to be laughing about?
I guess scrap that idea then.
Yeah.
Okay, imposing.
Imposing, huh? Oh, I've got it. Let's try this.
Ah, you know what? That looks good.
This pose! It makes me recall Sphina de Rosula's glorious golden age.
So it's good, right? We're good.
Isn't Clementine's pose a bit too bold and heroic? Was she really that kind of person?
Well, then one of us can be imposing, the other one can be, looking out into the distance.
You're right, though, that this may not accurately represent the image of her in our hearts.
Well,
let's try to come up with something else.
Well, Mr. Callus can do the thing, right? And then... Mr. Callus... No! Oh god, we're gonna be here for the whole day.
We tried a bunch of different ideas, but none of them felt right! Paimon's all out of brain juice now, too.
Man, if I knew I was going to do a photo shoot with the Traveler, I would have prepared a lot of outfits and props ahead of time.
Ah, what a tease. Because we don't get enough skins for characters, Navia.
Oh, outfits! Ugh, that's the errand I forgot back in the city. Do either of you still remember that girl? The girl I went to see with you two.
Oh.
Her name is Adele.
She was the one that we met while investigating Mr. Callus' case, right?
She always believed that her father, Jacques, was a good man.
Yes, that's exactly who I'm talking about. So, after the case, she was finally willing to talk to me. And she told me that she wanted to join the Sphina too.
Ooh.
I said that it's fine, but young children are not allowed to join the Sphina. She will just have to wait a few years, and then we'll welcome her with open arms. Since she's still a child, though, she thought I was just trying to let her down gently. I came up with an idea. I'd have a Sphina uniform made and give it to her as a gift. But I got so busy and distracted in the city that I forgot to pick the uniform up. So I did forget something important after all. On the matter of the statue, we should still come up with a few more ideas for the design. I'll have to trouble you to source some for me.
Navia! Florent, guess who's back?
Coulter, hi.
Huh? But aren't you supposed to...
Oh, well, if it isn't Coulter. Back already from the Fortress of Meripede?
That's right. I finally finished serving my time. Gotta say, it turns out I was a lot tougher than I thought.
A member of the Sphina in the Fortress? Why? Why were you in prisons?
After I got out, I immediately made a beeline back to Poisson. You could say that familiar, briny smell became a primal call, urging me to forget everything else and just come back home. You wouldn't believe how much I've missed Melissa's grilled fish. I dreamed about it every time I had to get a welfare meal down there underneath the sea.
At least the fortress is not too bad.
Let me introduce you. This is Coulter, another of Sphina de Rosula's members. He was found guilty and sentenced to the Fortress of Meripede some time ago. But, looking at it now, it was probably another one of Marcel's plots while he worked at the confrérie of Cabrières.
Wait, Mr. Marcel? What do you mean? He was involved in some sort of plot?
Oh boy, you don't know. Of course you wouldn't know. You were in prison.
Well, I know that Fontaine got flooded, but then the water levels miraculously receded. I thought that was all there was to it and didn't care to ask for any more details.
The prophecy was wrong.
Do you mean Mr. Marcel was somehow involved with all that?
Let me just catch you up real quick. Mr. Marcel... Newsflash.
Looks like we'll have to explain everything from the top. That case... A lot of things have happened in Poisson since then. First things first, let me introduce you to these two.
Heyo.
They're my most trusted partners, and they've been with me through thick and thin. Now you could call them Sphina de Rosula's VIP helpers.
Nice. Sphina de Rosula always seems to attract great people. Oh, that reminds me. Where are Malus and Silver? Aren't they always by your side?
About that.
You know, Navia, it's fine. If you don't feel comfortable, do we really want her to recount that event herself? Just when the wound was closing up.
They lost their lives, keeping me safe during the flood.
Still said
it. What did you say? This isn't some kind of morbid welcome home prank, right?
No.
You're just scaring me on purpose because I don't know anything about what's happened.
I have to say, this asshole really knows how to act.
Not just it's them, but true. Like half of Poisson.
They weren't the only people we lost either. Many others, including Melissa, also lost their lives in the disaster.
Luce and Melissa, dead. They're just gone? Luce. I was planning to give him a surprise gift once I ran into him again in town. I can't believe it.
Malus and Coulter were friends for many years, and even served on many missions together during the early days of the Spina. I can understand how he feels.
Let's sit down somewhere, so I can tell you everything that has happened while you were gone. Fair warning, there was a lot.
You really want to be the one to explain everything? Dang it. It went from taking pictures to this. God.
All of this, it's unbelievable. I can't believe that those stories were real. It all really happened. Has the world gone mad?
Had I not personally experienced all those events, I would have also found them very difficult to accept. I mean, hell, Coulter, consider yourself lucky.
I think you and I both feel the same way about the profound tragedy of Melusa's loss, the sheer depravity of Marcel's actions.
I thought Mr. Marcel would always stand by the Spina. Everything he had, the Spina gave to him.
The good news is that the Confrérie of Cabrières is no more. Gone with them too is the entire synth manufacturing and distribution network.
But if Marcel wanted to rebel against us, he probably sent word in secret to Romeu.
Not a name I've heard before either.
Oh, is there someone left from that we haven't found out about?
You see, there was once a major internal dispute regarding funding the construction of the Aquabus lines. Romeu was the leader of the faction that thought such a vast sum of mora would be better spent improving the town of Poisson. But Mr. Callus believed that an opportunity to collaborate with the Court of Fontaine and the Fontaine Research Institute was hard to come by, and would allow us to build many valuable relationships. Not only would the Aquabus be a good business investment, it would also boost our reputation among the general populace, eventually paying us massive dividends down the line. But the two couldn't come to an agreement. Romeu ended up taking a lot of people with him when he left Spino di Rosula altogether.
This is what's gonna be.
And the split was on extremely bad terms.
This is what's gonna be the main story.
It used to be a lot better with taking counsel. With him listening to our advice, and Ms. Clementine also frequently on our side, it was pretty smooth sailing for a good many years. But on the matter of the Aquabus, even Ms. Clementine completely stood by Mr. Callus's side.
They believed that Ms. Clementine lost her ability to serve as an impartial mediator when she became pregnant with Callus's child.
They thought she had betrayed them? That doesn't make any sense. Before she was their mediator, my mother was also her own person, and a member of the Spina. She should have the right to take any side she wished.
Yeah, but to them, even taking a side was betrayal enough. They felt like their voices could no longer be heard once their sole mediator had gone over to the other side. Of course, Ms. Clementine then passed away, and Mr. Callus began to regard the completion of the Aquabus project as her final wish. With that, the last hope of reconciliation was gone.
So that's what happened.
From that point on, Romeu and his people cut ties with the Spina. It never gave us any kind of professional or personal courtesy ever again.
Where are they now?
I've also heard that they aren't in a good financial position, so they've been lying low for a while.
Is their base also underwater, like every bad guy Fontaine base?
Even though Marcel's faction has been dissolved, we still don't know anything about Romeu's whereabouts. If they're still trying to get revenge on us, with how distracted and vulnerable we are, now would be the best time.
We should keep an eye on them at all times. I'll let my men know right away.
Poisson can't catch a break. The flood may be over, but there's still more threats for Poisson.
I've heard so many incredulous things today. I'm finding it a bit hard to calm down even now. I mean, to think that I'll just never see them again.
Okay, I'm going to assume for now that Coulter sounds like a good guy. Just don't let the story go in a direction that turns out, oh, Coulter's actually some kind of messenger or like an observer for Romeo, and that he came out of the fortress to do just that. Let them organize stuff. Let them be a threat.
Oh, you poor thing. You were almost on point.
Why don't we go back to the court? I can pick up Adele's uniform while we're there as well. It'll save Laurent's guys a trip.
I'm sorry if I'm too paranoid. We want to see the future star of the Spina.
We really are the best of partners. Come on, let's...
What was she?
Are we not taking the boat this time?
It's nice to walk from time to time, isn't it? Think of it as something like a hiking trip.
We're hiking
Once
in
we're
the
there,
storm.
We can stay a few days before we return.
A horrible timing with the weather, by the way, Genshin.
Since we're out for a walk, we shouldn't stress too much about the destination.
Sure.
I've grown old, so I'm not as fit as before. It's a good thing that at least my work down in the fortress was quite the workout. Malus and I must have traveled this way hundreds of times. When we were tired, we would lay down for a while on the grass, and when we were hungry, we'd catch a fish or two. The Spina was still on the rise back then. Mr. Callus was generous, and everyone had the chance to strike it rich. So, of course, we all worked really hard. And now, in the blink of an eye, the Aquabus lines have been built, and this road has fallen into disuse.
I don't really think that's a bad thing, though.
Oh, I know. I was just being a little nostalgic.
Then, let's stay here a bit longer. Anyone want snacks?
Yo, hold on. Let me just open my backpack full of, like, a billion food items. We can have a whole picnic right here, Navia.
Oh, is this another chance to try some of Navia's macarons?
Oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. Navia's macarons specifically? Like the burger-sized ones? Diabetes moment. That's gonna rot my teeth.
Let me check if I have all the ingredients. Malus and Silver used to take care of tasks like this.
It's fine. We have plenty in our bag, and I'm sure it's okay.
Okay. The stove's looking
good. Now she has to do everything herself.
And as for the ingredients...
You can see how everything reminds her of the loss. Navia bakes a batch of macarons with her usual gusto.
Whoa! These macarons look and taste magnificent! Your cooking is as good as ever, Navia.
Boss's baking skills have always been famous. Everyone in the
It is the good old burger-sized macarons. Oh my god, I miss these. What is like this size, bro? It's literally... Imagine taking a bite out of that and it's all just sugar. Dude, that is gonna fuck you up.
Have you two seriously never considered joining us? You're so close to the boss, and she obviously trusts you with all her heart, so...
There's still some important things we must do, like, hey, find Aether. For Navia, I'll risk heart attack and diabetes. Honestly, though, same.
Adventurers never stay in one place for long. The name of Spina di Rosula would just tie them down. Besides, after everything we've been through together, I'm sure our hearts would remain intertwined even if we found ourselves on opposite sides of the world.
One day we'll leave Fontaine again, just like Sumeru. I know I said this already, but when we do, I feel like I might even cry just picturing like Farina saying goodbyes. I'm getting sad just thinking about it, and that's not even gonna happen until next year.
Even if Paimon was far beyond the horizon, she'd still remember the delicious taste of Navia's macaron.
I'd remember you, Navia, more than anything.
We've got no wine with us, but let's still toast with water in celebration of this moment.
Hell yeah. I don't... I thought I heard something just now. Was that just some soul critter? Is Romeo's gang already at work? Cheers!
May your travels go smoothly.
Yippee.
May the Spina continue to grow.
Who's behind the...
And may our friendship last until the end of time.
I'm about to blow that bush up.
Hey there, Ludovine. How's business lately?
Ah, the demoiselle of Spina di Rosula. I must say, your generous patronage is the one thing keeping me from going bankrupt. Are you here for the uniform?
Yep. I forgot to drop by earlier when I was running errands around here.
It's just a uniform, after all. Any of your folks could have come instead.
Navia's always liked to take even small things seriously.
That's not the only reason I'm here. We mostly just needed a walk to clear our heads. There are few things more uplifting than taking the first step on a new journey.
Boss has got a point.
Going on a trip with friends is always better than staying
I see your ass there. Who the hell are you? What are you sneaking over there for, huh?
Please, wait here while I retrieve the uniform for you.
Can someone remind Paimon again why Adele wants to join the Spina?
She hasn't given me any concrete reasons. All she says is that she really looks up to me. She said she used to be terrified of Papa. So, as a result, she found all the rest of the Spina super scary as well.
Who are you?
She mustered up the courage to talk to me, and felt like I could really understand her.
The two of you have contended with similar circumstances.
Yeah, you could say that. By uncovering the truth about the case, I was able to give her closure at the same time. Let's focus on giving her a great atmosphere to grow and thrive. She can commit to us once she's older, and can really make that decision for herself.
It's a terrible way to hide. You just walk out of your hiding spot after that and act like nothing? Dude, we saw you, so I wasn't just hearing things.
Is something up, Traveler?
Follow me, someone's telling us.
Huh? Tailing? Oh, Paimon's coming.
I'll go check it out, too.
Oh, okay.
Coulter, please hold on
to this
for me.
She heard.
All right.
You stay safe, Coulter.
Paimon saw them, too. Oh. They headed up.
Go.
Stop right there.
Oh, it's all of them. There was three of them telling us? Hey, got you. Got your ass.
We knew you were going to be difficult!
Are you Romeo of Slots?
Seems like if we want them to talk, we're gonna need to teach them a lesson first.
Trial Navia moment?
Brothers, there's no need to skulk in the dark anymore. Let's take them out!
With you guys? Trial Navia, let's go.
Let's light it up! I'm going in! Yoo-hoo!
American breathing, first form!
Watch out! Chakaya! Hey there!
Oh, it feels good though.
Hiya!
Her shotgun feels good.
Now, talk. Who are you? And why were you tailing us?
Recognizing your situation, and don't entertain any fantasies of escape. They brought knives to a Gunbrella fight.
Stop playing tough, and start talking. There won't be any room for negotiation once the Maison Gardiennage gets involved.
We're looking to get vengeance on Spina di Rosula.
Romeo Slot.
Wait. You're not Romeo's followers, are you?
You actually know that name? Then surely you should understand why we hate you
much! I would advise you to stay calm.
We were out drinking when we saw Navia. We got so angry we decided to follow you guys and look for an opportunity to really mess up your
day. Really?
Too bad you guys messed up ours first.
You're lying.
Huh?
You followed us all the way here.
You're pretty sharp. But so what? We didn't do anything.
That's still stalking.
And now it should be pretty obvious that we can't do anything to you anyway. Seeing you like that just really ticked us off. And we let the drink go to our heads.
Listen, Callus is long dead. No matter what happened in the past, I want to be able to start things anew.
Will they listen? Will these type of people listen?
I am the current president of Spina di Rosula.
You tell them,
Navia. If your boss wants to talk with me, I'd be happy to meet with him. I won't press charges for your attack. That should also help demonstrate my sincerity.
I understand. Thank you.
Okay.
I'll let our boss know.
But if you so much as think about pulling something like this again, I won't be so lenient next time.
Do you hear?
Understood.
Her cocking the Gunbrella? I mean,
are you sure it's okay to just let them go like that, Navia?
I don't want to inherit my father's grudges, too. Moreover, when it comes to the Aquabus, I don't think what my father did was entirely correct either. If the other side is willing to talk, I'm happy to open the door for a reconciliation. Opportunities for new beginnings are all around us.
I support Boss's decision as well. The concept of an eye for an eye is a primitive practice that has no place in today's Spina di Rosula.
We don't need to resort to something so, violent.
Now that we've sent them packing, we don't have to worry about those guys anymore. It's getting late already. So why don't we stay the night in the Fleuve Sandra? We can head back to Poisson tomorrow.
All right.
Sure.
I'll also, why don't you go wait for me at the restaurant? I'll go do some prep and I'll get someone to tidy up your room while I'm at it.
Her voice actress really does her justice. I'm sorry, I have to say that again. They're so good. Fontaine's VA is so good. It's spectacular. You enjoy a fantastic meal as well as a wonderful performance. As things slowly die down, you return to your room with Paimon and soon hear a knock
Hello?
At the door.
Hello? Are you asleep yet?
Navia, did something happen?
Oh, no, not at all. I just figured that since we don't get to enjoy nights like these very often, we should try to enjoy it to the fullest. Wanna go fishing?
I've got some rods and lures ready.
Oh, late night fishing? Hell yeah. Ah, that smile again. Fuck, it's so bright.
Okay, let's go to the fishing spot.
Yeah, I even have like...
How can you call this fishing when you're using a fully automatic rod?
You just want to chat.
What's the problem? Lots of people in Poisson use rods like these.
Honestly, Paimon's mainly shocked at how much energy you still have at this hour. Usually by this time of night, it's a struggle for Paimon to even keep her eyes open.
It might just be something that runs in my family. I'm sure you'd get even sleepier if I delved more deeply into it. Anyway,
yeah.
I was just thinking about how grateful I am to my mother.
This is a chance for us to talk.
As well as the rest of the Spina.
Your mother?
My father always had a lot of unrealistic expectations for me. But the more that he tried to get me to become like him, the less I wanted to listen to what he had to say. My mother never had those kinds of expectations, though. I've heard that she had only one wish for me, which was that I would have a happy and secure childhood. All the members of the Spina greatly respected her wish, so no matter what I did as a child, they were happy to humor me. Can you imagine? Whenever my father wanted to scold me for something I'd done, everyone would form up into two rows and just stand silently and listen to him rant. Malus and Silver were always there too.
That sounds so ridiculous.
Eventually, Papa must have recognized scolding me over trivial matters was pointless, because he eventually stopped getting on my case so often. Looking back on it now as an adult, I can hardly believe how patient and kind everyone was.
It was thanks to that you grew up. You're strong.
When I was young, I often thought that I could do whatever I wanted, because there'd always be someone there to clean up after me. But once, I saw Malus come back wounded. He wouldn't tell me how he'd been injured, but I could tell it had something to do with me. I learned then that there's always a cost to making a mistake. The more you care about those around you, the more you should care about doing the right thing to the best of your abilities. Because if you do falter, there'll inevitably come a time when you'll have to face the consequences. And when that time comes, those most precious to you really will throw themselves in front of you and pay the price for your mistakes.
Navia, it must really be hard for you.
Sorry.
No.
I shouldn't have brought that up.
It's completely fine.
I wasn't planning to talk about sad things tonight.
It's like the only place you can't really let it out.
Basically, I was just saying that the nurturing atmosphere of the Spina must have been my mother's legacy, rather than my father's. And if that's the only way that I can continue to feel her love, then I'd like to pass that warmth on.
Is that why you let those guys go today?
Mm-hmm. Although, maybe there's a part of not wanting to repeat the mistakes.
That better not come to bite us back.
I want to be reasonable, at least.
She tries to do something nice, but no. Someone like Romeo is just too foolish to realize that. I really hope that's not the case.
Hey, look! I think you've got something on the line!
After some time, you finally manage to reel in the prize catch together. For the rest of the night, your rod continues to rack up catch after catch, while for some reason Navia can't seem to hook a single fish. Aw, no! Navia's quite upset about her bad luck, but it's only when you begin to head back to that Paimon discovers the real reason to the mystery of why didn't she get a single bite.
You didn't attach a hook to your line?
Lord, Mom. God, Navia.
Stop wasting time! The boss ain't gonna wait all day! We'll go ahead with the operation tomorrow. Do with that information as you wish.
No. No!
Well, your rod was missing a part, too, so I guess that was makes that it fair.
Is that what I think it was? I was just saying, he looked like a nice guy. That better not be the same person. They're gonna pull a Marcel again, aren't they?
See you tomorrow.
Oh no. Is she gonna be okay?
Ah, so how was last night? Did you get a good night's sleep?
Paimon dreamt that she danced with the sea stars! So you could say it was stellar. You get it?
I was kidding. I didn't think they'd do it again. You, why? That was you, wasn't it? Yeah. Two of the things I wish didn't happen. Coulter being a bad guy. And that Navia's kind-heartedness fell on deaf ears. Fontaine, what is wrong with you?
Adele, we're back. We brought you a gift from the court, too.
Whoa, thank you so much, boss.
Ah, right, it's the family we saved.
Don't call her boss, okay, Adele? Just Miss Navia.
You're not working under her yet. The uniform's just a promise.
Oh, it's all right. I don't mind. Besides the gift, I've also got another surprise. Yoo-hoo. Guess who's here?
It's been a while!
Hello again.
It has been a while indeed. Thank you so much for your help on Jacques's case. I've heard that you also helped save all of Fontaine. You're truly just like the great heroes of legend.
You're really amazing! And if Miss Navia's your friend, then she must be super amazing too!
Oh yeah, she's incredible.
What's in this thing? Can I look?
Of course. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's the uniform. It's a bit big. You gotta wait a couple years.
A Spina di Rosula uniform! Is it for me? But isn't it a bit big?
You're still a kid. You gotta wait until you grow into it.
Well, it's a gift for future you.
Exactly.
When you first told me that you were interested in joining the Spina, I was overjoyed.
But you're too young.
But
it's mafia work.
It's Spina's responsibility to protect everyone as well.
Mm-hmm.
Being a member means becoming involved in all kinds of dangerous situations. And since you're still young, I don't want your mom to have to worry about your safety.
Oh, so that's it. Well, thank you so much, Miss Navia. I'll work hard and grow up as fast as I can.
Good to hear.
It's the least we could do. As long as you live in Poissant, even if you're not an official member, you're still part of the family.
Boss!
But
I've got something urgent to report. Romeu and his folks have gathered outside Poissant and even shipped in a huge pile of explosives!
They're assaulting Poissant now.
What? Explosives? What do they want?
Seems like they've got no interest in sitting down and talking at all. We should have gone straight to the Maison Gardiennage.
Sorry. I underestimated the situation.
Because you're in on it, Coulthard.
Too late now, I suppose.
Sheesh.
Florent, where are they keeping their explosives?
On the hill to the east of Poissant, near the Clementine line.
Wait, that could mean they're just gonna...
They want to blow up the Clementine line?
Certainly sounds like it.
Romeu and his followers hate the Spina, and everything to do with Callus. And the Aquabus was the source of their contention. If they manage to blow up the Aquabus line, all that rubble will come crashing down the hill and straight into Poissant.
Like a cave-in, it's gonna block the entrance.
Are they insane? There's tons of innocent people in Poissant!
They hate us, they hate Callus, and everyone associated with him. We have to stop him.
Yeah, we have to issue an evacuation order to the townspeople, and get them as far away from the entrance as possible. That should save them from the worst of it.
Again? This is the second time they needed to do evacuation for Poisson. Let's get this sorted as fast as we can.
That should be the safest place.
My dear partner, can I leave the Clementine line to you?
100%.
If the explosives do go off, not only would the people of Poisson be in danger, any aquabuses using the line would plummet to the ground.
What is wrong with people?
Let's stop their insanity first.
They literally just lost half their residence.
Leave it to us, Navia. Please stay safe, too.
This Romeu guy, swear to God.
Let's go, you two. We've got to act fast. Miss Coralie, please take Adele to the ship.
No. Oh no. The fuck are you gonna do? Hey!
Watch out, boss!
You son of a... Oh god, is Florent okay?
What do you think you're doing, Coulter?
He was gonna do it right there and then. You were gonna kill her?
I thought all the annoying little hindrances had left, but I still couldn't get rid of you.
It's another Marcel situation. It's Marcel number two.
You mean this was all a trick? So that you'd be left alone with me? Coulter, are you with Romeu too? Oh. I get it now. You knew about their plans all along.
There's a kid here, too.
You only told us they were doing badly so that we'd drop our guard.
Of course, they're actually loaded with more, aren't they?
Not quite. Though I share their positions on some issues, I've never cared for his more radical ideas. And that's because Out of the entire Spina di Rosula, I only hate you. Only you, Navia.
What did she ever do to you?
Romeu promised me that he would leave Poisson alone if I could just take you out. But it was like you were glued at the hip to that pesky traveler. You never gave me a chance to make my move. Romeu has lost his patience. I didn't have to be here today, you know. But I swore that I'd kill you, even if it meant being buried with you in the rubble. You never saw the heyday of Spina di Rosula, nor did you ever live through the golden age of Poisson. I saw it all with my own eyes, and then I had to watch it all die, little by little. And it was all because of you, Navia. Clementine died because of you. Callus died because of you. Melusin Silver died because of you.
That's not
her. So many more.
How can you blame that on her?
Everyone dead. All because of you.
None of that was directly her. I'm gonna keep saying Fontaine villains are so thick in the skull.
Now you're catching on. I heard Malus was dead the moment I got out. Did you know? Down there in that blasted fortress, I spent a long time thinking about what happened and resolving to apologize to Malus as soon as I got out. Back then, because of that aquabus, we had a huge fallout. I was convinced that all he cared about was loyalty and that he had completely lost his capacity for critical thinking. The years passed by in a blur after that. I thought I had finally begun to understand him, and that he could help me relive the good old days again.
But he's gone.
But then he died, and it was because of you again, Navia! It's always because of you!
How could you...
I once loved the Spina and Poisson more than anyone else. But what is left now of either besides death and ruin? You've single-handedly destroyed everything that was beautiful. Everything I've ever loved.
That is literally because of the flood.
Don't listen to him, boss. He's just spouting nonsense.
Have you ever considered that maybe the people around you don't actually care about you at all?
Really?
Have you ever considered that maybe you only get respect because you're Callus and Clementine's child? That you've never done anything worthy? That you're just a big nothing? Have you ever considered that? Maybe people don't stay in Poisson because of you, but only because they have such beautiful memories of the past before you came.
This is so painful to watch. Christ. Navia's just, it's not even a joke anymore. She's just not getting a break at all. It's just constantly people reminding her, attacking her of the loss that she didn't even, it's hurting her as much as it's hurting them as well. I just feel it's unfair. You know, all of the thing with her mother, Clementine, Callus, it all happened in such a chain reaction. And her getting thrown the position of president, you can't fault everything on her for that. It's just... Oh no, I'm not...
Because if you do falter, there'll inevitably come a time when you'll have to face the consequences. And when that time comes, those most precious to you really will throw themselves in front of you and pay the price for your mistake.
We just talked about that last night.
Looking back on it now as an adult, I can hardly believe how patient and kind everyone was. Is that really why they support me? Is their kindness...
Don't let it get to your head.
Shut your mouth! I, for one, really like Miss Navia. And my mom loves her too! I don't know how to explain it, but I like her, and that's that!
I'm sure Mr. Malus would be extremely disappointed in you right now! You've somehow managed to pin the blame for every mistake and tragedy in our history on the boss herself!
Mm-hmm.
Get out of the way, Florent! I don't want to hurt you.
You already did.
Maybe you think you're being the realist by painting the history of the Spina and Poisson like this. But the love that I felt from everyone was just as real. I felt it. They've helped me get to where I am. And even now, I will continue to believe in that love. So let me show you just how much I love the Spina di Rosula.
Okay. All right.
Hiya!
A person living in the past
That's his thing.
Watch out!
Ooh, and ended off with the blast? Hell yeah. That's what you deserve. One of them's dressed like Jacob. Jesus.
Laurent, I'll leave the town to you. Summon the other members and help with the evacuation of the townspeople.
Stay the fuck down.
I can't allow my partner to face the danger on the Clementine line alone.
I'm sure we're fine.
Boss. I'm on it.
I'm sure we're fine.
Are you okay, Navia?
I don't know, but I have to go.
A short while earlier, you and Paimon dashed to the entrance of Poisson.
Let's hurry up there. We have to protect the Clementine line. If they're gonna blow up the waterway, they must have planted the explosives next to the support pillars.
Oh, shit.
They certainly brought a lot of muscle. They're really slowing us down. But if we're meeting resistance, we must be heading in the right direction.
Oh, it's... Oh my, did you see...
Hey there!
It has quite the range, too.
Yo,
I am digging the Gunbella.
This is the control mechanism.
Probably not the brightest idea that I use her burst, which is like a barrage. It's powered... Of course, the annihilation reaction. They're abusing that as a bomb. I noticed that now. It's both Uzi and Numa. They're using the reactions.
There's a strangely shaped
hole here. To deactivate it.
What is it for?
Maybe an emergency switch. Anything? No, you just... Bro has a whole radish stuffed in there. Okay, so where's Bro hiding that? You know, those kind of questions, that belongs in the forbidden knowledge.
Navi and Florent should be able to relax now.
Oh, we should still check the perimeter just in case.
Oh, you're right. They could have set explosives elsewhere too. Let's go.
So I'm guessing, like, Navi's kit mainly relies on... Oh. Oh, no! There's more bombs on the hill! Of course it's not just here. Oh shit, Ruby! Oh, she's using elements again! Finally! I haven't seen her use Geo in years! Block it, block it.
Great work, partner! Just leave the rest to me!
Oh?
This the
Spina way. Oh, hold on. She is. How does she make an action scene look so majestic? And her burst. Dude, and the guitar. The guitar. Y'all hear the guitar. What an action scene! What the hell? Oh, ah, did it? Yeah. Oh my, that was fabulous! Holy, you see how cool that was? She was like, and then she had to.
I heard from Thierry that even they're your enemies now.
She put
they
the
once a part of Spina.
She did the burst in the cutscene.
Plan to settle this privately with them.
She did the burst in the cutscene. That's so badass. What? I guess like shooting them and exploding them like decreases the momentum because I was worried that the other rubble would actually fall anyway.
Regardless of whether their hatred and anger towards me or the Spina was justified.
Dude.
Anyone who's willing to endanger innocent civilians is no longer sane enough to even be worth trying to talk to.
Gave us a bomb-ass cutscene, though.
Prosecute them in accordance to the law.
And Jacob looking guy.
Spina di Rosula will not raise any objections.
We won, Navia! We saved everyone! And you are so cool!
Yeah. Luckily, we were just in time.
You look a little pale, feeling a bit fatigued. Yeah, she was emotionally attacked, and then she had to play off that whole... It looked badass, but it was probably very exhausting to pull off. You look a little pale, feeling a bit fatigued.
It's probably because I expended too much elemental energy at once. I'll be fine.
Don't worry about me.
That can't be it, right? That's just what she thinks.
Boss, we managed to catch all the infiltrators in the town. The Maison Gardiennage is taking them away as well.
You bitch.
Coulter.
Being the kind person and forgiving person Navia is, she's probably not gonna, you know, even if he might have tried to attack her. She's the kind of person to give,
you know. I can understand how you feel.
See? She's...
The things that we lost.
She's just too good.
They're forever beyond our grasp now, and that makes them appear even more precious.
She's too pure for this world.
I am not callous, and I will also never become him. The Spina and the Poisson that you loved are both gone, but... I will not change how I feel about our future. I still believe that this is a great opportunity to start anew. I will spend more of what the Spina earns on the betterment of Poisson. What's more, I'd also like to propose some changes to the Aquabus routes, so that one day the people of Poisson will enjoy the boons it brings as well.
I know what you're trying to say. Mr. Callus would never have said anything like that. There are too many things in life that are just beyond our control.
Like you.
In that, we are the same.
Henceforth, you are no longer a member of Spina di Rosula. But once you're discharged from the fortress again, you're welcome to pay another visit to Poisson.
She's so forgiving. It's hard to watch. She gets so much shit all the time, and she's still willing to give them a second chance. This is just the type of person Navia is. This world doesn't deserve Navia.
Thank you, Navia.
As I thought, Boss really is a kind and gentle person.
You don't say. The most kind and gentle of them all.
She is also, I must say, a truly unlucky person. Thank you for protecting the Clementine line. I was actually really scared, you know. I mean, even the Callus line won't be getting rebuilt anytime soon. If I'd lost the Clementine line too, I wouldn't know how to live with myself. A name is a way to etch a memory onto the world. Losing the line that bears her name, that I can see every day, would be like losing my mother all over again. Seeing it still standing there, tall and proud, it makes me really happy.
It's okay, everything's fine now. I'll get you back to Poisson.
Thank you so much. Can you give me a hand? I really don't have much strength left. Traveler, I want to ask you something.
She's exhausted.
Please, tell me the truth. Do you really see me as your partner?
Oh, fuck yeah, of course.
Of course.
I can't, this game does too much to me.
That's good then. Hearing that, it brings me more relief than I can say.
This world doesn't deserve you.
How do you feel, Navia? Any better after taking a break?
How is... A character like Navia in Genshin in Fontaine of all places.
I feel quite a bit better, but I should probably still rest for a few more days. Sorry, partner. I said some weird things earlier. Feel free to just ignore me.
A little weird, that's true, but that's because I never heard you doubt yourself before.
I used to think that
you're
I'd
a
never
great partner,
doubt myself.
Navia, okay.
You could say I've discovered that I'm not as strong as I thought I was. Coulter mentioned my parents, as well as Malus and Silver. It's all thanks to them that I've made it this far in life. Do you think they ever regretted the choices they made?
No. Not for a
single
moment.
Has my existence made this world a better place?
Of course it is.
Don't think like that, Navia. You've already done more than enough. No matter what others think, we'll always support you to the end of the world.
Well, since it's ended up like this, I suppose it's time for me to make a confession as well.
What?
There's something that I've been keeping from you as well, boss.
Please, follow me. Everything is already prepared.
Oh, is it a... Wait. Is it the statue?
Don't worry. This surprise will be a pleasant one.
Is it the statue? Oh, please. She needs this right now.
Why is everyone gathered here? And what's... this?
Right? This was supposed to be a gift to you from everyone in the town.
Or...
We were originally planning to show it to you once it was finished.
But?
But special times call for special measures. I've never seen you look so defeated before. So I've decided to show you the designs before the final product was done.
Take care.
Do I really look that bad?
Well, if you're ready, I'll unveil the present.
What is it? What is this surprise? Oh, it's the design for it. Oh, they included her.
This is...
Her mom and dad looks great
in
it.
Papa, mother, and me.
See, I said you should have done Callus with the crossed arms. Oh.
We designed the look for Miss Clementine based on old camera records, as well as personal recollections from members of the Spina.
They even went to the length to...
Wow! This is the statue you mentioned before?
It is indeed.
It's amazing.
To be honest, we decided on the design a long time ago, and gave the sculptor permission to begin working. We only asked Boss to decide on a design so she wouldn't realize we had already started.
Hi, you sneak.
How could we only
bastard.
Have statues of Mr. Callus and Mrs. Clementine?
Even though Boss is still young, we've all seen the work she's put in regarding the whole synth business and the rebuilding of Poisson.
We wanted to commemorate her contributions with a statue as well.
I don't know what Spina di Rosula was like in the past, but I know it's a great organization now.
With Navia around, we're not worried about this place's future.
We're gathered here today to tell our boss that we support you and believe in you wholeheartedly. I believe everyone is here for you.
You're gonna make her cry.
That's what we believe as well.
I will always believe in the bond between us.
Thank you so much, everyone. Then I'll be brave and just accept everyone's support for what it is. This really is quite the surprise. I never thought that I'd have the chance to stand next to my mother. Not even in my wildest dreams.
And it's gonna end here. Wow. Of course, the ending card rolls. Dude. What the fuck? If you want to keep the picture, take a picture. It'll be gone. Whoa, okay, take a pic. Okay. Thank you. That's such a well-designed sketch. God. Callus is drawn perfect. Everyone's drawn perfectly. I think they really did a good job on, like, piecing together what her mom looks like, too. Come on.
It seems like I started to question myself a bit too much. I'll pick myself up again and become a more reliable president all of you.
You're already great.
Looking back on it, I'm honestly embarrassed by how I acted earlier.
It's fine. You were exhausted. About the gifts from the townspeople.
I'm sure everyone longs for that one thing in life that seems trivial to others, but they themselves can never
attain.
Good
idea, Scythe.
To me, that would be a family portrait. I've always been super jealous of other people's family photos. I've never thought I'd receive a family portrait of my own. Especially not like this. It seems like I'm not such an unlucky person after all.
About Clementine. By how
I... You know, I've thought about it before. Though my mother only wanted me to live a happy life, that's actually a tall order as well. In practice, it's just as hard to achieve my father's expectations for me.
Yeah, being happy is a bit... It is a challenge.
Even though my parents had very different personalities, they always had a lot of respect for each other. The Aquabus project was a monumental project that stood to benefit all of Fontaine. It would have been a little close-minded to assess or evaluate it only from the perspective of the clan. I think that's probably why she didn't step in to mediate or oppose the building of the lines.
About asking, do you really see me as a partner?
Oh, Whoa. Why'd you have to remind me? Please don't say that again. It's super embarrassing for me. Oh, forget it now. Please forget that I ever said anything.
No.
Wait, but it'd also be bad if you were to
exactly.
forget it.
Exactly. Which one do you want? I'm remembering it.
Okay, but please keep it a secret between us from now on. Please don't ever mention it again.
I mean, it's as I expected, right? I expected depression. I got depression. A lot more than I was expecting. So, I mean, you saw how bad I felt for Navia. Especially in the second half of the story quest. It was just horrible. This world doesn't deserve someone like Navia. Holyoverse is cruel to a lot of characters that just want to be happy. At least in the end, we made up a little for it by showing her the design for the statue. For those of you on YouTube, thanks for watching the video. Make sure to like and subscribe, and let me know your thoughts down in the comments about the story quest. Thanks for watching the stream and joining, guys, and for watching the video on YouTube. See you guys next time.